Before we start the show this evening, this is world premieres, finally. So, and it's a product of Carbon Area School District, the school board, who has been willing to spend the money to invest in new lights, which has allowed us to give these effects, and allows us to do brand new type of plays here because the lighting has been improved dramatically from what we had before. So I'm thrilled with what Carbon Area School Board has done, and I truly believe that it will enhance the plays here going forward. So the dark ages are over, and we've got the 21st century ready to rock and roll, let's put it that way. This is a product developed by Mr. Farrell, an English composition, advanced composition teacher, Laura Hardiman, who, when I suggested that we should have a new playwright series here at Carbondale, they bought it in entirely. And so what has happened is we had 9 plays submitted, and we chose 5. The other, not that the others were bad, but they were screenplays. There's no way we could put them on the stage. So, but I think moving forward, this is something that we should continue here at Carbondale area. Abington Heights has one, Roland Paulpack area, Scranton Prep, Mountain View occasionally does this, but I don't know of any other schools in Lackawanna, Susquehanna, and other counties that do this type of thing. So this is usually what colleges do. But I think it's really important to give students, especially the seniors who wrote the plays, and they're all seniors, an opportunity to express themselves on the page and give us an opportunity to take it from the page, put it on the stage. And that means working with the lights, the sound, and everything that goes on to put it on a play, which is not easy. This is the second performance of this run. And I hope you enjoy it. They're all 5 different, diverse plays, ranging from an interesting tale at the beginning, where Little Red Riding Hood meets the Tin Man, and to the next one, which is a lot more serious, and it has to do with drunk driving, to the third one, which is a wonderful piece, I think, written by Audrey Murphy, that has to do with Does Size Matter? And I'm gonna let you figure that one out when you see it. Then we're gonna take an intermission. And in the program, it says Size Matter starts the second act. We had to switch it around a little. The Letters, written by Caitlin Dovin and Olivia Regal, that will open the second act. And that one's an interesting tune about, it's about friendship, about forgiveness, and about let's not hold grudges. It's not worth it, it's bad energy. And the last one, written by Wilson Rodriguez, is a kind of a combination of Star Wars and real life. So I'll let you judge that one. Anyway, I appreciate you coming out. If you enjoy this type of theater, you think we should go move forward with this project, please tell the school board. You know, these plays are not easy to put together, especially new ones. We had to sit down with the writers and edit these plays. So, and I hopefully they learned something from it. So, with that in mind, is there anything else I haven't said? Probably, but it's not worth me wasting your time in trying to figure it out. So, anyway, first act is about 30 minutes long, maybe 35. We're going to take a 10 to 15 minute break. And the second act is probably 25 minutes. So, it's not a long night. But I really hope and sincerely hope you pay attention, support these students, and if you like, please tell the school board, Mr. Farrell, it will help this program move forward. Okay, with that in mind, the first annual New Playwrights Festival here at Carbondale Area High School. Thanks for coming.
Who's that? this anymore. So tired of catching people and eating them for lunch. I don't even taste good anymore.
Are you okay?
No, if I was okay, I'd eat you for lunch right now. So tired of being the big bad wolf. If I was human like you.
Well, if you promise to behave yourself, I can take you to Granny's, where she may be able to fulfill your wish.
Are you pulling my tail?
No, she's a potion that makes bad people good and good people better.
Take me with her, I promise to behave.
Okay.
It's in that basket of yours.
I promise to take you to Granny's, but please don't touch my basket.
Sorry, I meant no harm. I was just curious as to what was in that basket. Someone's coming.
Hello, hello. Is anyone out there? Please don't be afraid. I'm very lost, but I promise I'm very friendly. I'm from Oz, not this per se village. Ah! Go ahead and eat me, I'm heartless.
What?
Stop, you just promised to behave. I'll leave you right here in these woods.
I'm sorry, I don't know what got into me. It's not a lot, and I promise to behave.
May I ask, what are you doing in these woods this whole afternoon?
We're going to Granny's house.
Secret.
It could be our little secret.
Fine, we're going to Granny's to get a potion to turn me human.
I'm doing the same. May I come to request?
Why do you want to be human, Mr. Tin Man?
Well, I've always wanted a heart, but deep down I want to find a true love in my life.
Well, the more the merrier.
Oh boy, I always wanted a real heart.
There you go. Looks like a storm's brewing.
Come on, follow me.
Listen, there's a very good reason for this secret.
Fine, you have 2 minutes to explain yourself.
Well, you see, I had to bring the potion to Granny because it had to be baked in with something.
See, I told you she had no explanation, you idiots.
Deacon, I warn you.
Stop! Here you go, there's something here. Are you guys sure you would like to turn into human?
I'm sure. I always wanted a real heart.
I'm sure. I'm tired of being feared. I want to live in the village with everyone else.
What about you?
I'm fine the way I am, and so should the Tin Man and the Big Bad Wolf.
All right, well, dig in. As the Tin Man and the Big Bad Wolf ate their cookies, they saw no physical difference. The Big Bad Wolf gained a conscience and turned into the Big Good Wolf. He got to live in the village with all the others. The Tin Man got a heart which led him to the love of his life. Yeah. I never thought I'd have to do something like this in my life.
He's got so much stuff.
Put it out.
He was so drunk that night, he shouldn't have gotten in the car and tried to drive.
Especially someone as smart as Andre.
We were all acting stupid that night, but it shouldn't have been him to get into the car and try to drive.
Hey, remember when we went to DC together?
Yeah, and when the taxi guy got mad at us because Andre spilled his coffee in the car.
The dog's in the car, let's go.
We have a minute.
Alright.
I can't believe he had a little disorder and now has to end up in a shelter.
Poor Dimitri. I bet if he would have remembered that Dimitri was at home waiting for him, he wouldn't have gotten into the car and tried to drive.
If only we didn't live in dorms, I would take him in immediately.
Same with me.
Come on, guys, let's go.
We're coming.
Come on.
We're coming.
I don't care. Come on, let's
You're
go.
You're not even in the car.
I can't believe this. He's so dumb. He doesn't think. He never did. He doesn't realize how it affected me or my life. Everyone's just dumb. I can't stay in this room any longer.
No, I didn't forget. Well, I have a lot of stuff I have to get in for tomorrow. Yeah, sorry. I gotta go, I'll see you around, bye. I miss you, Andre.
Jazzy, what you up to?
Jazz and Kalei to start tomorrow in this program.
Oh, for what?
For Andre.
Oh, yeah. I'm so sorry that it happened.
I am too. And that's why I can't just sit here and let this happen to more and more people. It's time somebody realizes this is not okay and that somebody should do something about it.
Yeah, I agree, but where's Boris?
I don't know. I've been trying to call him all day and he hasn't responded. I wish there was more than just me who wanted to do something about this.
Well, I'd be happy to help.
Great.
Hey guys, how's it going?
Good. Hey, we're starting an awareness program. Would you like to help?
Sure, count me in.
Awesome.
Why is it so hard to say goodbye?
Because we can never go out with breakfast with him again. We can never go to walk on. We can never see him ever again.
Boris, we're all going to miss him.
My name is Andre Carter, and I died from drug trafficking. Due to drug trafficking, I affected everyone's lives around me, including my family. Because of my decision, my dog passed to live in a shelter. Because of my decision, I made it difficult for my friends to even connect with one another. Because of my decision, I could have harmed someone else in the process of harming myself. Because of my decision, I will never be able to apologize for the hurt I caused to those around me.
Driving. And every year, 239 kids are killed due to drunk driving accidents.
Adults, or even students like Andre, do not realize how the decisions affect other people's lives.
Every decision you made since you woke up this morning has affected someone's life in some way or another.
Making smart decisions is the easiest way of keeping you and those around you safe.
Drunk driving is a decision that can affect your life and someone you care about.
Stay sober or stay off the roads.
Hey, Genghis Khan, save some water for the turtles.
Oh, good one.
Thanks. I've been working on that one for a while.
You're funny.
And you know what? It was funny. He thinks he's so cool with his fabulous emo hair and his tight jeans that show off his nice...
Hey, hey, there's a noisy eating competition contest at McDonald's.
Babe, what do you think?
About what?
You're starting to get a little...
Ready?
No.
Independent?
No.
Ready?
No.
Come on, David, not mine, reader.
You're getting fat. And I can't date a fat chick. My friends already make fun of me for dating.
Hey, you old Christian! I didn't know you were dating an Asian!
No, I'm not Asian.
She's got more cheese than a Chinese phone book!
Alright, let's get out of here. You're not wanting to be seen with a fat chick.
Whoa, she's fat and ugly. You don't want that. See you, man. You're dating a fat chick.
I'm sorry, Max.
It's over.
Can I at least give a hug to five?
I don't hug fat girls.
Hey, yo, Bob, what did I tell you about passing notes in class?
I don't know what you're talking about.
If it's not a note, let me read it in front of everybody.
I'm sorry, I can't let you do that.
You know, I got a question for you. What are you and your girlfriend got in common?
Both have real hands?
I don't have real hands.
And nope. You both have detention after school. I'll see you then.
Accept me, but they didn't. My life still sucks. I mean, if I don't like myself, then why would I change for anybody else?
Yeah, well, you understand what I'm going through, so why don't you just stay out of it?
Max, you're beautiful.
What?
If people can't see that, half of them are idiots in the first place.
So what's everyone at school about?
Basically.
Why are you being so nice to me?
You might be the biggest girl in school, but if you weren't here, it wouldn't be the same without you. And I don't want to lose you.
Wow, that's the nicest thing I've heard from someone in a long time.
You want to go get food?
Sure, I'm hungry.
I'm starving.
Hey, Max, does Molly eat chicken nuggets at McDonald's? Well, fine. I hope you get big and fat and turn into a...
Is she okay?
Yeah, she's dramatic and everything.
Does this happen normally?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, how do you think? Maybe I love you.
Let's go get some. Let's go get some.
Sure.
Is anyone gonna help me?
Okay. Yeah, she told me she's had a long day of doctor's appointments. I believe her though. I think she was jealous if something was wrong. Did the doctor mention anything wrong with her? No, just old days, that's all.
At least we know she still has her good sense of humor.
That's for sure. If Cheryl loses her sense of humor, that's when we should worry.
You're right.
Will you finish cleaning up dinner and I'll go check on her? Yeah, if you else need anything.
Emily, call 911.
What?
Get an ambulance here. Grandma's gonna wake up. I think she's dead.
What? Hi, it's ambulance. 47 Oak Street. My grandma's
up
a while ago and she won't wake up. 47 Oak Street. I think she might be dead.
Yes, please. Yes, Oak Street. 47. Please hurry.
I'm sure she's slowing down as we speak.
Hey, Mom, why don't I get those old memory boxes in that grandma's closet?
Great idea, Emily. I'll go grab them.
I think they're near your bed. Yeah, right there.
I got them.
What are all these letters?
I don't know. Let's check it out.
It says to Mary Jane. Dear Mary Jane, despite our past, I am writing to you a sincere apology. I know that we have not gotten along in recent times, and I am to blame for that.
But I wanted to inform you that in my old age, I have realized there is no sense in feuding. The last time we spoke, I sensed you still had not forgiven me for stealing Michael away from you.
Are you sure?
It's right here.
I knew how much you loved him, but I let my feelings get the best of me, and I lost sight of what's most important, our friendship. For years, I felt that Michael did not love you the way he deserved to be loved, but I never had the courage to tell you.
Oh.
On the warm August day, when you asked me to meet for lunch, I didn't think anything of it. Just a few minutes after we sat down to eat, I realized we were on a date.
Oh.
And I had real feelings for him. I had known for years that I never felt this way about someone before, not even my own husband.
What?
When my husband passed away, I never thought I would love again, but during that lunch date with Michael, my heart was so full. I laughed more than I did in years, and I was so caught up in the moment, I did not even realize what I was doing. And I know what I did to you caused you more pain than you could ever imagine, but if you could find it in you to forgive me, I would like nothing more. No one ever found out about our date, so if you can, please forgive me. If you choose to accept my apology, write back to this address. I'll be waiting. Sincerely, Jane.
Wow, I knew Grandma was a little crazy, but I never expected this. Did you know Mary Jane at all?
Yeah, Mary Jane was Grandma's best friend, and then one day she just stopped talking about her.
Well, this is why you haven't heard about her. She stole Mary Jane's husband. There's some more here. I wonder if these were more husbands she stole.
I certainly hope not. I mean, what more can she have hid from us?
She did hide this.
Oh, Mother.
And I am so sorry that I got the job you've wanted for years now. I did not think I had a chance of even getting an interview when I applied, or else I would not have applied, or else I would not have done it.
Listen to this one. My dear friend, please forgive me for forgetting your 50th birthday. It completely slipped my mind. I want to make it up to you. This is Gloria wrote. That's enough for that one. You don't need to hear about that old age getting to her again.
Hey, Mom. This letter says that Mary Jane only lives a couple blocks away. Do you think we could give it to her?
That's a good idea. We can bring it over in the morning.
All right, I'm going to head into bed.
Okay, good night.
Good night.
Could it
Hey, Susie, what are you doing? Listen, I'll pick you up tonight around 7, take you out to dinner, and then whatever happens, happens.
Who told you that? Never mind, it doesn't matter.
I am not two-timing you. That is ridiculous. You are the best. Look, you want to go out or not? Great. You are something special, you know. I mean it. Okay, see you tonight. My place or yours? Sounds good? Okay, see you tomorrow. Man, oh man, you Jack are the man.
Entire life. Woo!
got some work to do. All right, let's get this. Hey, let's go.
Go where?
Does it matter? Go. Your life with such greed and injustice.
This can't be. This is a trick.
Your eyes, Jack, are not deceived.
I won't let this happen. I won't. There has to be another way.
There's actually one way.
Please tell me. I'm begging you. I can't live like this.
You have to change your ways.
I don't know
how. Well, Jack, what are you telling me? Live a life of humility and drop all this ego stuff, and you know what? Stop hearing about the superficial, because you have the potential to do great things.
Yeah. I think I can do it.
I believe in you, Jeff. Now, we actually need to proceed.
Not now, kid. Get out of here. Oh!
Help, freeze! No, stop! What are you doing?
Hey, yo, chief, can you help me with the flash? Get to see I'm freezing!
I don't care!
You know who I am!
Yo, Italian, get out of here! Turn around. Do you see what I mean, Jack?
Yeah, I think I do.
Well, good, because I think you can get on this path and you're going to stay on.
What if I can't?
Well, don't worry. Our escapades are long. Long, long, long way from Bellingham.
Wait, what?
You heard me. Now, I'll show yourself a favor. Get on the phone, call Jameson, and apologize.
You know what? I will call Jameson.
Yeah.
I'm not going to fire him after all.
Yeah, so will we, buddy. See you tomorrow night. I think we can all admit that Jack over there has a long way to go. But I think he'll be all right. Now let me tell you the real reason I brought all of you here today. It's to deliver a warning. That if you feel like the path you're on is the wrong one, beware. Because you might be seeing me in your dreams one of these nights. But I guess that's all I gotta say. Hopefully you don't see me tonight, huh? Good night.
There's nothing you can make that can't be made.